court system.
I'm Tom Martino, and today we're talking about divorces, as you know. And I've seen a lot of divorces cost so much money and get really, really nasty. Lawyers can be so expensive. And people tend to fight for every last asset just out of anger. Often, there's another way, better, faster, cheaper. I know from personal experience. I went through mediation, and what it could have been tens of thousands of dollars ended up costing me less than $5,000. Scott Barraway is an attorney. And Scott Barraway, he was tired of divorces in the system. And Scott, you founded the Divorce Help Center.
That's correct.
What a great name, the Divorce Help Center. And it's all about mediation.
It is. It is. I think there's truly a better way than the litigation system to help people get through divorce.
I mean, divorces, I had a friend, personal story, a friend, who spent everything they had fighting. Mm-hmm. There was nothing left for the kids. They just went after each other.
Yep. Well, I came from the inside representing people for many, many years in divorces and saw that happen repeatedly and figured there had to be a better way. There just has to be.
And you're telling me with mediation at the Divorce Help Center, you see cases come and go for how much?
We see them come in and finish without children for under $2,000 frequently and with kids for between $3,000 and $4,000, including all the paperwork.
And here's something I want to tell you about the Divorce Help Center. You cap fees. You guarantee capped fees. In other words, if they come to you, there is a cap. They will not spend any more than $3,500 for a couple or $5,000 if children are involved. And you're saying that many times it comes in under that.
Very frequently it comes in under that. But it doesn't matter if you have 2 sessions, 5 sessions, 10 sessions. You change your paperwork 10 times. Your fees are capped at those for the entire case.
Do you mean fees per each person or for the couple?
No, for the couple.
So $5,000 guaranteed for the couple with kids or less many times.
Absolutely.
What's the secret? What do you do?
The secret is that we use a process. We have a lot of experience, a lot of training, and we use a website to help people learn about the law.
So before they even start mediating, they can go to your website, which we'll give out in a second here. It's at the bottom of the screen, and we'll show a full screen of it later. But they can go to your website and see short videos that explain processes.
Correct. Yeah. Initially, we spent a lot of time trying to teach people what the foundation was of the law and what the ground rules were that everybody worked by. We've developed a website over a couple years, put videos up, put PowerPoints up so people can educate themselves. So when they come in, they know what the guidelines
are. They're ready to
go. They're ready to go.
Because courts will often order mediation anyway.
Absolutely.
And that's after they've spent maybe $5,000 each or more on attorneys.
Almost every court in this jurisdiction will send you to mediation in a divorce case before a judge will ever see you.
So it just seems logical to me that you would start with mediation, see how it goes. I mean, of the people that come in, how many stick to mediation?
90% we reach a conclusion on and sign off on their paperwork and get divorced. I'd say at least 9 out of 10.
So 10%, they come in and you know pretty well they can't do it.
They do. And if that happens, they know within the first 2 hours it's not going to work, and they choose the litigation approach.
And that just costs them a few $100.
Correct. They know that early.
So 90%, though, are able to get it done, even with kids, for under $5,000. I mean, this really should be, in my opinion, the way divorces are.
I agree. And most of our clients come in without lawyers. I mean, that's our preferred model, is to come in on your own, learn about the law, bring us your issues. You don't have to get along. You don't have to have agreements already. We're trained to work with that. And we take you through a process, make sure you understand what you're doing, reach an agreement, usually send you home to sleep on it for anywhere from 3 to 7 days to make sure you're really comfortable with it. And if everybody's comfortable with it, then we start working on the paperwork. We get signatures, you take it to the court and file it, and you can be divorced 91 days after the case is filed.
And 91 days is only because there's a cooling off period.
Correct.
That the state requires. But you are an attorney at law, so you can draw up the documents.
Right. Yeah, Colorado does require you to be a licensed lawyer to draw up the documents.
And you're a licensed lawyer doing mediation. You do the mediation?
I do the mediation. That's correct.
Okay, so are you representing who then?
We don't represent either side. Mediators are allowed in Colorado to be neutral. We let them know from the start. We certainly tell them if they reach a resolution, if you want to consult with a lawyer, you can take
sure.
the agreement to someone.
Yeah. But that would still save them a ton of money.
Absolutely.
If they spent the time with you hashing out an agreement and then took that agreement to a legal counsel if they wanted to, you're still going to save a ton of money if you want personal representation. What do you think the biggest hang-up is when people come in that do not mediate? What's the biggest hang-up?
I think they're really scared that there's some secret out there that if they don't get a lawyer and they don't go in and fight full bore, that they're going to lose out on something. And the law is just not written that way.
Is it often anger?
There is anger, but we expect disagreement when you come in. You can come in angry. If you didn't have disagreement, you wouldn't be coming to us.
So you know? you're equipped to deal with that.
Correct. Yeah. Absolutely.
And do people usually end up pretty well satisfied?
Yeah, I think most people are very happy with it. I've rarely had satisfied clients in divorce cases when a judge mandated what everyone was going to do. If you can reach an agreement where that you know what you're going to do and you've agreed to it, you're almost always happier than having somebody jam it down your throat.
You were named a Colorado Super Lawyer, which is a good accolade, and also the 2010 Mediator of the Year in Jeffco.
Yeah, and Jefferson County Mediation Services out there. I do a lot of pro bono work with them and help low-income families through this exact same process.
And we're proud to have you on the referral list because I think it is so important, the service that you give. So what's the process? I know people are listening saying, wait a minute, maybe I want to do this. So do they go to your website first or give you a call first? What do you want them to do?
The process is great. You go to the website, look over the videos.
Look over everything.
There's a link on there to send it to your partner. It says so your partner can get an anonymous email or from you that links right back to the website. You both look at it and then call. You set an appointment, either talk to your partner or call us individually, and we can help facilitate the first meeting.
And in the first meeting, is everyone together, or is it a kind of mediation where people are in separate rooms? Here's your website, by the way, where people can look at videos.
Great. Yeah, what they're showing right now is the video vault. It has videos on every area. There's basically four areas in divorce law that need to be dealt with.
What are those four areas?
Property and debt distribution,
okay.
Child support, parental responsibilities, and spousal support, or what we used to call alimony.
Okay, and so those four main areas are explained.
They are all explained with PowerPoints and slides to tell you what the standards are that every judge in the state uses.
You know what's good about this? Since you are an attorney and you see divorces, and you've seen many divorces, you can pretty much say to the couple, this won't fly, or this will fly, or this is what judges probably would say. You know, you give them an idea of what the outcome may be so they're not wasting their time.
Well, we rarely try to predict what a judge is going to say, but we can generally tell you that's reasonable and that makes sense.
Right.
But if two parties agree to something, that's great. Most judges will approve their agreement. The key point is, did they agree to it?
Okay, so here's how you get in touch with them. The Divorce Help Center, divorcehelpcenter.com.
Divorce.net.
Help Center, oh, I'm sorry, .net. Divorcehelpcenter.net. And here's the number, 720-889-2808. 720-889-2808. Again, divorcehelpcenter.net. Divorcehelpcenter.net. 720-889-2808. 720-889-2808. Thanks for being here. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Divorcehelpcenter.net.